About that, we have learned what is a variable means, right? So variable is nothing but name given to a memory, right? And also identifier for a memory, right? So how do I get a data from a memory, or how do I store a data into a memory? That identifier is nothing but a variable, right? And also we can define it as name given to a memory. Now when you are giving a name to memory or a name to a variable, class or a function, right, you have to give name to variable, function and class. So that is called as an identifier. Now when you are giving a name to these things like variable, function and class, we must need to follow certain rules that we have seen yesterday. Should not start with number, should not contain special character, it can be alphanumeric, no keywords, all these rules we have seen yesterday. So the next topic what we have seen yesterday is, how do I assign a multiple variables with the same value on one line, right? Multiple variables, x, y, z, each same value, 10, 10, 10, on the same line, one line, right? Also we have learned, how do I assign multiple variable with multiple values on one line, right? So means x, y, z, I want to give values 10, 20, 30, but I won't do all these things on one line. So we have seen this yesterday, right? Next we have seen is, okay, fine, I wanted to store the data in memory. Program is all about data in, data out, that's what we know, right? So when you wanted to store the data in a memory, right, we need to know how much memory I need, right? So at that time we need some identifier to see like how much memory we need to store the data. That identifier is nothing but a data type. Data type will help us to determine two things. One, what is the data this variable is storing, what is the type of data this variable is storing. Second, how much memory I need to store this data. These two information will be provided by data types. Yesterday we have seen there are multiple data types. There is one numeric. Under numeric we have seen there is a int, float, complex, bool. Right, then we have seen list, tuple, set, dictionary, range, right? So all these data types we have seen yesterday, right? So then after that we have seen operators. So what is an operator? It is an entity which will help us to perform operation on operands, right? So there may be an A plus B. A and B are operand here, plus will be an operator, right? So there is an operator which will help us to do an operation on multiple operands, right? That is nothing but operator. Now there are multiple types of an operator, different types of an operator. We have seen assignment operator, comparison operator, logical operator, right, assignment operator, we have seen identity operator, there are new operators into an Python, right, identity operator, right, so all these operators we have seen yesterday, right. Next point we have learned is comments. As I explained to you guys, when you go into an enterprise world, when you go into a large scale industry and write a code, the number of lines of code may not be 10 lines or 100 lines, it may be in lakhs of lines or millions of lines of code, right? When you wanted to write the code, comment plays very very important role, because comment will give an idea about next 100 lines of code, what exactly it is doing, right? So instead of reading entire 100 lines of code, what this 100 lines is doing, what is important is reading one line or two lines of comment to understand that what exactly this code is doing, right? This is needed especially when there are chances that engineer will write the code and he will move on to the next team or next company, right? When the new guy will come in place of older guy, he should be able to ramp up himself very fastly, understand the code, what is written by somebody else, very quickly. So for that purpose, comments is very very important. I hope till this everything is clear. right? So we have spent 5 minutes to understand what exactly we have learned yesterday. Now, what we are going to learn today, next topic, is a conditional statement. What is that? Conditional statement. Right? So these are the topic which we are going to learn. Right? Next is conditional statement. I'll just paste this into your chat so that you know what exactly we are learning. So see, any doubt guys, you just ping me on to this chat, okay, so that I can stop there and try to answer. Okay, you can unmute and talk to me, okay, not a problem at that time, right? So let's go and start learning about conditional statement. What is the conditional statement, right? What is the conditional statement? The statement which will have some condition, right? There will be some condition in a statement. If that condition is a true, then only next block of code will be executed. There is a condition, right, under which there is a block of code. If that condition is true, then only that piece of code will be executed, right? There are numerous times we need this kind of an operation, that I wanted to execute this code only if this condition is met. I wanted to execute this code if this condition is not satisfied, right? There are numerous times we need this kind of behavior in our programming, right? At that time, we need to have the conditional statements, right? What are those conditional statements? First conditional statement is nothing but if. What is that conditional statement? First one is if. If. So now, when you say if, right, what is the exact syntax of this if? So as I said to you, right, if will hold some condition. If will hold some condition. Now what is that condition means? We can say it as an expression. So if will have some expression, right? So if this expression is nothing but condition, I am saying. If this expression evaluates to true, right, it may be an like a less than 5, b greater than 20, or age is less than 18, or age is greater than 18, right, or marks is greater than 50, marks is less than 50. All these are expressions. So if this expression is true, then only the block under this will be executed, right? Block under this will be executed. Now this block will be created with equal space, right? Under this if statement, I can have a block with like multiple statement, like statement 1, right, like this, then statement 2, right, statement 2, like this. I can have n statement, like a statement n, right, like this. I can have multiple statement in a block. Now you understand that I have created one block here, right? This statement 1, 2 and n will be executed if this expression is true. Now how do we write this statement 1, 2, 3 so that it will come under if? Is you have to use equal space here. Equal space. Either you use one tab, or you use one space bar, or two space bar, or three space bar. But all these three statements must be equally spaced. The best way is to use a tab, right? Single tab. Tab, tab, tab. Now, if I write any statement, like I will remove this n, I'll just keep it as a 3. And if I write now here statement, S-T-A-T-E-M-A-N-T, statement 4. Now you see, the statement 4 is not under the if block, right? Because you have written this outside the if. You have not given equal space. If you give equal space, then only it will come under this, right? You just started this statement just below the if, right? In that case, it is not under the if block. Now, the statement 4 will be executed always, whether this expression is true or false. Doesn't matter, right? If the expression is true, expression is true, then statement 1, 2, 3, 4, all will be executed. If this expression is false, only statement 4 will be executed. Hope you are understanding, right? Take an example. I want to give one example, right? Take an example is, what example I can give? Take an example, I want to see whether a person is eligible for voting or not, which we have seen generally. So, you know what is the criteria for voting? There is an age factor will come into a picture, right? Let's take an age. You guys know how to take an input from the user. How do I take an input from the user? What is the function? Input. What is the function? Input. Input will help us to ask user to enter certain details or give certain input, right? So, I can say enter your age. Enter your age. This is the information I am getting it from the user. But you guys know that this information, what I will get it, is not an integer. It is a string. It is a string because by default, whatever the data you get it from the user will be using an input function will be always string, right? It is my duty to convert into an necessary type which I wanted to have it. Now, age will be always integer. So, I will use int function to convert this string into an integer. Right, so I just use this int. Now I got an age, I converted that into an integer and I stored in a age. Now I must need to check whether this age is greater than 18 or not, because only then he is able to go and vote, right? Otherwise he is not able to vote, and I wanted to check whether he is eligible for voting or not, right? So then what should I do right here? I will be doing one thing is I will write here if. Right now my expression means anything, right, which will evaluate to result true or false, anything which evaluates to true or false. Now how do I make it? Like age greater than equal to 18 or greater than 18 is allowed, right? So this is my condition or expression which will result to a true or false, right? If this is a true, under this if of one tab, I am going to print you are eligible for voting, right? I will print here you are eligible for voting. You are eligible, right, for voting. And this is what I am going to do. Clear. I hope you understood now, right? So, and if I want to come out of this block, I can just print outside of this if. Something like I will print here, print end of program. End of program will always be printed because it is outside of your if. End of program, right? So understand this, guys. See, I have given you how the syntax of if will be, right? And I have given you one program for that, right? So now let me execute this and then see how the result will be, right? I'll just remove this, right, and then let us run this program, right? So what this program is doing, it is asking the input age, storing it in a memory, giving the name to the memory as age, then evaluating the expression if the age is greater than or equal to 18. If it is a true, it will print you are eligible for voting and end of program. If it is a false, it is straight away it is going to come out of the if block and print end of program, right? Let's run this, run and run the model, right? And we must need to save before running, and I saved it. You see here it is asking me enter your age. Let me give age as a 19. So what it is printing, you are eligible for voting and end of program, both the statements it is printing. I hope you are understanding, right? Right, let's take an example. This time this expression evaluated to true because I have given age 19, which is greater than 18. Let us give an age this time less than that. So run model, right, and then enter your age. I'll give a 17. Now you see it has not entered into an if block. Straight away it went outside of if and it printed end of program. Understood, guys? Understood? So this is how if works. This is how if works, right? So this is the first conditional statement. First conditional statement. Now let's learn the next conditional statement. Like, what if I wanted to have I want to print if person is not eligible also, right? You can't just say like you are eligible. You should also say like, sorry, you are not eligible, or better try next time, something like that. Some nice information we must need to give if the expression is evaluating false, right? The one way is I can use if and if one more time if, right? One more time if, but that is not right. You guys know that. If I use if and if two times, I am going to waste the time of execution, right? So when you are executing, you are going to check if the age is greater than 18. Even if it is a true, again you are going to check whether age is less than 18, which is wrong, right? If the first statement is true, let me write it. Let me write it. Like I will be writing like if age is less than 18, right? So I am writing this now. Greater than 18 is over, less than 18, right? So I will say here print, you are not eligible, right? So I can say here, you are not eligible, right? So say, let's take an example, enter your age, I have given 20, this is a true, first one is a true, it will print you are eligible for voting, again it will go and check whether age is less than 18. Which doesn't make sense, because you already clarified and confirmed his age is greater than 18. So you don't need to waste the time in checking again one more condition. So in that case, how to avoid it? Instead of using again if, I have one more thing called other than else. I have one more thing called other than else. So I'll use else block. Right? If and else. If and else. So the expression, again the syntax will be something like this. Syntax will be something like this. There is a if expression, under that there will be a statement, and there is a else, right, colon, and under that there will be a statement. Let's take an example. I'll bring this statement 4 here, and let's have outside statement 5. Right? You see this, guys. Now, statement 1, 2, 3 are under if, and statement 4 is under else, and statement 5 is common. Whether if executes or else executes, statement 5 will be always executed. Right? Understood? I hope you understood this. Correct? Right? So, let us run this. Right? Let us run this program. Right? If and else. So, run and run model. Right? It will ask to save and run. So enter your age. This time I will enter 12. You know 12 is less than 18. So if will be false. If will be false, and then it will go to the else. If will be false, then it will go to the else. It will print you are not eligible. You are not eligible, and then end of program. Understood? Let me run this one more time for true condition. Run model. Right? So enter your age, I will enter 22 this time, and it will print now you are eligible, because this time it will execute if block and then directly come out. Understood, guys? If and else. Understood? Right? So if somebody wanted to write quickly, write this. I'll just give 1 minute. Right? If somebody wanted to write. How many of you are new? Anybody is new? Or everybody is old only? Anybody is new, guys? No. Are you able to hear me? Yes, no.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. You are able to see,
right? Yes, sir.
Yeah. Okay. So, new guys, don't worry. I am going to have one more class separately for you guys, which will be a little slower and little in depth. Okay, don't worry about that things. That's what I wanted to say, and don't hesitate to say I am new. We are going to cover this. Okay, so the old guys, you guys know, right? This is the thing which we have learned, and I'm trying to explain one more time. Okay, got it, guys? So look at this program. I'll give 1 minute. If you are writing, write it. If you are not writing, you just see this how it is. Just 1 minute. Okay. So, on the similar line, we'll see one more program. Okay. So, on the similar line, we'll see one more program. One more program will be, let's how do I check whether number given number is even or odd, right? So, how do I check it, guys? You guys know. Enter a number. You can say here, enter a number, right? So, anyone be a number. So, I will not say age. I'll say here number, right? Num. And let's check whether number is even or odd. So, how do I check? If number modulus 2 means I am trying to divide the number by 2. Modulus will check whether remainder, what is remains. After division, what is remainder? Remainder is 0. Remainder is equal to 0. Means I am able to divide the number completely. I am able to divide this number, whatever the number I am getting as an input from the user. If I am able to divide this completely, then remainder will be 0. Divide by 2. Any number which is divided by 2, when you divide by 2, the remainder has to be a 0. If it is 0, the even number is even number. So, I can say this number is even number. Right? Even number. Right? And else, if I am not able to divide the number completely, then remainder will not be 0. Remainder will be 1. Right? So, when the remainder is 1, then this condition will be false and it will go to the else. When it goes to the else, I must need to say that it is an odd number. Correct? It is an odd number. That's all. Understood? Very simple. So, you see there, that if an expression and statement, else and statement. You see here. There is an if and expression which will evaluate to true or false. And if it is a true, it will run this. Else, it will run this. Okay, got it? Let's run this quickly. Run mode. Save and run. So it will ask enter a number. I'll enter 11. So it prints odd number and end of program. Because you divide a number, number is 11 now. 11 by 2, remainder will be 1, which is not equal to 0. So this condition will be false. 1 is equal to 0? No. So, which is false. So, it will go to the else and it will print odd number and then end of program. Right? Let's run this one more time for even number. So, run model and enter a number. This time I will give 22 and you see it prints even number. Because if you divide 22 by 2, remainder will be 0. Remainder will be 0. So, I hope you understood if, then if and else. If and else. Right? So, these two. Right? So, the next thing we will see is what if I need to have, see this if and else is helpful only when you have two conditions, either this is true or other one is true, right? So, either it is a head or tail, right? Either it is a black or white, right? So, it is a two-sided, right? So, two-sided condition you can use a if and else. But what if I have multiple conditions to be evaluated? To achieve a certain result, right? Take an example. I wanted to say whether person is having a grade or B grade or C grade or D grade or fail or something like that, right? Or I wanted to determine whether a particular person is senior citizen or adult or not adult. All these things I want to check. Then we need more than two conditions. I cannot just rely on if and else, right? In that case, I need to go for a little more, right? One more level or two more levels, right? In that case, I need to go for third conditional statement. That is nothing but if and elif. If and elif. Like in other programming language, we say if, else, if. In Python, we say it as a if and elif. If and elif. So then how the expression will be? Let's write it. So control V. So expression will be like this. If the statement, see the if will be same as it is. If will be as it is. If and expression, right? Then not else, but there will be elif. Right? Elif will have another expression. Let's take an example. This is an expression 1. elif will have another, that is quarter than. You can give one space here if you wanted to give, it will look better. So I'll say here expression 2, right? Then if this expression is true, then I'll execute statement 2, right? I can have one more also, right? I'm lazy, so I'll just copy paste, right? So elif, I'll have one more expression 3. See, these are different conditions, right? Expression 1 is the condition 1, condition 2, condition 3. Right, if expression 1 is true, statement 1 will be executed, straight away it will come down. If this is a true, expression 2 is true, statement 2 will be executed, straight away it will come down. Right, if this is an expression 3 is a true, then this will be executed. I'll say here statement 3, right, and finally I'll say at the end I will have else, right, which is nothing but right, else is executed always, right. So if nothing is matched, this is not true, this is not true, this is not true, finally it will go into an else. So I will have here statement 4, right, statement 4, right. And you guys see this, so at the end of the program I have one statement called as a statement 5, which is outside of this conditional block, outside of this conditional block. So meaning that this statement 5 will be executed always, whether condition is true or false, doesn't matter, right? So this is the syntax, guys. So this is the syntax. Right? Syntax for if else, right? If elif, or you can say if else, if elif, right? So how it is? There is an expression 1. If this expression is true, this will be executed, else if. If this is a false, it will go to the else and if. So elif, this expression is true, this will be executed. If this is also false, it will go and check this. If this is also false, it will go to the else. That's how it will be. So how do I check it? Let's, you guys know, let's print and ask an user to enter certain marks and check whether the marks given is false or give us an percentage, and based on that percentage give the grade, right? Whether he got a A grade or B grade or C grade or D grade. So how do I do that? So let's write a program. First thing is, you are asking please enter your percentage. Enter your percentage marks, right? I'm talking about marks, percentage means, right? Enter your percentage, and here I can say percentage, right? So this is the percentage. I will have expression here. If the percentage, right, so this is my percentage. Percentage is a variable, right, guys? So if the percentage is greater than 60, greater than or equal to 60, let's have 60 also included, greater than equal to 60. If somebody gets a percentage of marks 60 and above, I'll say he got a A grade. Got it, guys? A grade. Elif, right? If somebody is not having 60 and above, then we need to check for whether he got less than 60 and greater than 50. Then we'll give him a break, B grade. So percentage not greater than 60 or equal to 60 means definitely it is less than 60. So I'll have percentage less than 60. And because I want to create the bracket here, I want to create an interval here, right? Between 50 to 60, right? Then I have to say, and percentage greater than equal to 50, right? You see how we created, percentage is less than 60 and percentage is greater than equal to 50. In this case, I am going to give him a B grade. Right, B grade, right? So this is how a B grade is formed, right? Similarly, we can have one more, right? I can have one more. I'll just copy paste. I'm also lazy, also and smart work, we need to save our time, right? So now I will check less than 50 and greater than 40, right? If somebody's marks is less than 50, because he didn't get above 50, right? He is having less than 50 and greater than 40 greater than equal to 40, I am giving him a C grade. Right? Finally, if it is his marks or his percentage is less than 40 also, then I am going to tell him like, sorry, you failed. Right? So we can say sorry, print. We can say sorry, you are failed. Right? You are failed. Better luck next time. Right? So this is what we are going to write. Right? So end of program. So end of program is something outside of your if and else. It is not part of your if and else. Right? So I'll just remove this, and this is our program, guys. Right? Ask user enter your percentage. If percentage is greater than or equal to 60, print A grade. Elif, percent is less than 60 and percent is greater than equal to 15, print B grade. Elif, percent is less than 50 and percent is greater than equal to 40, print C grade. Else, sorry, you fail. Better luck next time. Right? This is how our program looks for if and elif. If and elif. Like, let's run this. Run model. Right? So run model. Enter the percentage. I am going to enter 77. You see here, he got how much grade? He got an A grade. Okay. So let me clear. I can clear it. I don't know. Like, how do I clear? Okay. So let me exit this. Okay. So I will run one more time. So run mode. Yeah, so it came top because it was going down, right? So now next time I want to go for a B grade. Earlier 77 we have given, it went for A grade. Let's give between 50 to 60. I'll give 55. Now you see here, it is saying B grade. So it executed only this and came down directly, right? So next let's run for C grade. So C grade is between 50 and 40, right? So run model. Let's give this time 46, right? So if we give this 46, it says C grade and end of program. Let's take an example, last condition. This is also not true. This is also not true. This is also not true. It is going to come into an else. When it will come to an else, only when marks or percentage is less than 40, right? So let's give a percentage as a 35. So sorry, you have failed. Better luck next time. You see, an end of program is always going to get executed because which is outside of your conditional statement, right? So that means that has nothing to do with your conditions. Whether the condition is true or false, it is going to get executed every time, every single time, right? Understood, guys? So this is nothing but if elif, right? So three conditional statement we have seen: if, second one is if else, third one is if elif. Right? So finally, I'm going to tell you one thing is, so anybody wanted to write it or wanted to go through this, I'll give 1 minute. Please go through this. I'll pause for 1 minute. You want to see this? See it. Okay, guys. Okay, fine. 1 minute over. So let's go to the next, right? So the last thing I want to tell you is like nested if, right? How we can have if inside if. How we can have if inside if. That is called as a nested if. Nested if. Nested if means if inside if. I'm repeating multiple times. It is if inside if. Right, I have explained earlier also to you guys. So this will be like, and syntax will be like this, right? So there is an if and there is an else. Let's take an example. I'm going to modify this. So there is an if and there is an else, right? So inside this if, I want to have one more expression, right? If inside if,
there is one more if, right? So there is an outer if and there is one inner if. Here I'm going to have one more expression, expression, right? So here I'll have expression 2, right? So see that. So this statement has to be one tap, so that if the expression 1 is true, it will come inside, and if the expression 2 is also true, then only this statement will be executed. If the expression 1 is true and expression 2 is false, then it is not going to get executed. So in that case, what we need to do, it will go to the else of this, right? It will go to the else of this, and here the statement 2 will be executed. Here the statement 2 will be executed. Understood? See the hierarchy. See the hierarchy here. This expression, if the first condition is true, then only it is going to come here. This will be executed. If this is a false, then straight away it is going to come to else, and this is going to get executed. But if this is a true, it will come inside. We will check for expression 2. If this is a true, then we are going to execute this. But if this is a false, then we are going to execute this. Understand? Understand carefully. This else belongs to this if. This else belongs to this if. I can have one more if else inside the else also. If. Here I can say expression 3. Just copy paste. Here I can say expression 3. Right? If this is a true, then I am going to execute statement 3. If this is also not true, and then I am going to have else for this, and I am going to execute statement 4. Right? Understood, guys? This is how our nested if will be. Nested if will be. Right? So statement 4, 5 will be as usual, which is outside. Understand carefully. There is an expression 1. If this is a true, this block will be executed. If this is a false, this block will be executed. Even if this is a true, there is inside also a tree. If this also has to be true, then only this will be executed. If this is a true, this is a false, then this will be executed. Understood? Understood? Right? I have given a fair idea about this now. I'll give one example which we have learned before also. I have given that example before also. The marriage, right? Marriage for marriage in Indian culture, right? In Indian society, we have certain rules, right? So marriage. So there are two things we come into in picture when you say eligibility of the marriage. One is the age. Second is the gender, right? So that there is a different age criteria for different genders. If it is a male, the age has to be greater than or equal to 21. If it is a female, then age has to be greater than or equal to 18. So there is no same age for both the genders for marriage eligibility, right? So in that case, I must need to have if and else to run or write a program properly. How do I do that? Let me do this modification into this. I am not going to change anything. I'm just going to copy this, control C, right? And I'm going to paste it in your chat. Where is your chat? Yeah. So I hope you all have this, but I'm just going to paste it in your chat. Okay. So now, how do I change this? Right? How do I change this? Let's see this, right? So I will have here. See, two things I need, right? If I want to write this program now, I need two information from the user. One is the gender. One is the gender. Gender equal to, right? Then input, I'll say here, enter your gender. Enter your gender. Right? This is one information. Do I need to convert this into integer or something like that? No. Because gender is always male or female. So we don't need to convert this, right? Either M or F, right? So next one, it has to be string. So then next one is age, right? Then age input, right? So let's ask for the age. So we can say here, enter your age, right? I get an age also from the user. So, but you know, right, age has to be always integer. Let's convert that into an integer. So, integer function I have used and converted that into an integer. Right? Now, first thing is I'll check gender because I wanted to create the branch. Male means come here, female means go here. Right? So, I'll have gender here. So, my variable name is gender is equal to. You know, right? This is a string. String will be always in single quote or double quote. I'll say M. Gender is male. Else, what will be the gender, guys? It is a female. Yeah. Right? Now, inside that, I need to check age. So, here I'll check age. If gender is a male and age is greater than equal to 21. Right? Then he is eligible. So, I can say print. Then I can say eligible for marriage. Marriage. What is the marriage spelling? If it is wrong, just ignore it. Okay? If age is less than 21, it will come in else. Right? So in that case, we should say print, you are not eligible. Right? So we can say here, you are not eligible for marriage. M-E-R-R-E-G or M-E-A, I don't know, little confused. Okay, then if the gender is not male, then definitely it is a female, it is going to come into an else. So here again I have to check age. For female, age criteria is what, guys? Age is greater than or equal to 18. So in that case, I'll just simply copy paste this print, right? You are eligible. So I'll just copy paste here. You are eligible for marriage. Else, definitely you are not eligible because your age is less than 18. Right? So it will come here.
See here. See, outside if is just to bifurcate male and female. One tree we created, male or female. Inside that we are checking age. For male, it is 21 and above. For female, it is 18 and above. Understood? Right? So, finally, I'll just say print end of the program. Right? End of program. Understood, guys? So, let's run this now. Right? So, let's run this. Run.
Run model. So it has, it'll ask me to save it. I have saved it. Now it is going to ask me a gender. So I'll give a gender as a male and enter. It is going to ask me an age. This time I'll give 22. You guys know, if the gender is male, so if the gender is male, it is going to come here. And now age is 22, means this is also true. Then it has to print eligible for marriage. So it will print eligible for marriage and end of program. Okay, let me close this so that we'll get new shell. Now run this. Let's go for male only, but a reverse condition, right? So he is not eligible condition. How do I go for that? So we can say like, okay, enter your gender. So I wanted to show this both things. Okay, enter your gender. Again, male only we will enter. So male only. Age, this time I will give an 18. You guys know, male and age is less than 21 and he is not eligible. So you are not eligible for marriage and program. Got it, guys? Right? Next, let's, this time it is not male, it is a female. Then run the program. You guys know, if it is a female, this block will be skipped. It will directly go to the else. Right? So I'll enter. It is a female. Enter. Enter the age. I'll enter this time as a 19. Means for female, 19 is allowed. 18 and above is allowed. Right? So it is eligible for a marriage. And end of program. Right? So final condition is female, but age is less than 18. Right? Let's run this now. Run model. Right? So enter a gender. I'll go with a female, and age I'll give as a 17, and it says you are not eligible, and end up. Understood guys, right? So this is called as a nested if. If inside if, there is a if inside if, that is nothing but the nested if. Nested if. I'll give 1 minute, just observe this. 1 minute. Done guys? Done? Okay, so what we have learned? We have learned today conditional statement. What is a conditional statement? It is a statement which will get evaluated, which will have some condition. If that condition is true, then the block below that will be executed. Else, the block below that will be skipped. Right? So the conditional statements are very much necessary into an enterprise world. To bifurcate the programming language, right? If you wanted to execute certain piece of code not to execute a certain piece of code, we must need to have some conditional statement, right? The first conditional statement is if will be having expression. If that expression is true, the block below will be executed. Second is if else. So second will be if and else. So this will be like, it will help us to execute two conditions, right? If it is a true, execute that block. If it is a false, execute next block, right? Just now we have seen, number is even or odd. Number, age is greater than 18 or less than 18. Or gender is male or female. Such kind of things only we can use if and else. But what if we have multiple conditions to be evaluated when you wanted to run your program, we must need to go for if and elif, right? So it can hold multiple statement. If expression, elif expression 1, elif expression 2, elif expression 3, finally else, right? Next we have seen nested if, right? If inside if, there are the various times we must need to use a nested if, right? There is an expression top, and inside that you wanted to again branch it out, right? At that time you must need a nested if, right? So if inside if is called as a nested if, right? I hope you understood this, right? So we are on time now. We are hitting the 9 o'clock. 5 minutes are there. I will pause for a minute for any questions if you guys have. Any questions? Anybody wanted to say anything? Any questions? Okay. Somebody said once you explain about the comments, right? So comments, I'll just take in 1 minute. So in a chat, somebody said to me can you explain about the comments, right? So comments. Comments is very, very important, right? So, comment isn't just an information about I'm having 100 lines of code. I just wanted to write on top of that 100 lines, one line, what this code is doing. Let's take an example. I am writing below code validates the debit card pin. Guys, it is giving, let's take an example, I am writing 100 lines of code below, right, which is validating the whether pin card given by the user is correct or not, right? So you will get debit card number and pin, you go to the bank and ask them, okay, match this, whether the matching or not, right? So if that logic is 100 lines of logic to match that, then I don't need to read that 100 lines to understand what exactly is happening. I can read only one line. If I am new programmer into that company or in that team, I can read this one line and understand what below 100 lines of code is doing. I can just say that, okay, below code, validate the debit card PIN. Okay, good, super. Right? I will say like, okay, I'm interested in this 100 lines of code or not. If I'm interested, I will go and look into that 100 lines of code. If I'm not interested, I'll just ignore this. Because if my failure or my issue is related to credit card, then do I need to read this 100 lines code? No, I can save my time, right? This is the very much importance of this comments, right? If you write it, it will give a clear idea whether this piece of code is doing what and whether I am interested to look into this or not. Right? So second thing, this is a single line comment, guys. How do I do that? You can use hash. This hash is there in your keyboard, right? You use this hash, using a hash you can do a single line comment. See, at the same time, there are chances you can write an author information also, who is writing this code, and date also, date. So when you are writing this in code, right, author, date, all this information you can give it. So even these are multi-line, right? I can comment using this like one by one line, hash, hash, hash. But it doesn't look good for multi-line comments, hash, hash, hash. What if I have 5 lines of comment? Can I use hash, hash, hash? It doesn't look good. So in that case, I can go for multi-line comment. So remove all this and use triple quote. 1, 2, 3, single triple quote. Down here, end this with again triple quote. 1, 2, 3, that's all. This is multi-line comment, you know, right? Now all these 3 lines are not part of your execution. Program doesn't understand these 3 lines. These 3 lines are only for readability purpose. Only for readability purpose. This will not be part of your execution. This will not be part of your execution. Right? Because these are not instructions for a machine. Right? These are not instructions for a machine. These are